number 10 Miami at Duke. And the fact is, I just don't believe in Miami. They've been winning by the skin of their teeth. They've just not been playing good football. They should have lost a majority of games. They should have lost to NC State. They should have lost to Virginia Tech. The fact is, they were able to claw their way back into it. But it's just, it's not been going well. I don't think, the problem is, they're a one-loss team. They are, if you can actually believe it. They don't deserve to be a one-loss team. They've canceled a whole bunch of games. They've played bad games. But they're a one-loss team, and believe it or not, they're in the playoff conversation if some stuff happens. It's just, I don't like it, but Duke's been playing horribly. They started the season, I thought, man, David Cutcliffe has that team going again. They finally got a replacement for Daniel Jones. And, of course, they had a slump last year without Daniel Jones, but they played a really good game against Notre Dame, and I'm like, damn, Notre Dame's a good football team this year. And if Duke can compete against Notre Dame, then they compete against really anybody but Clemson. They just lost to Georgia Tech last week, and I'm like, oh, God, Duke, you're back to being bad again. It's not a good day when we see Duke football be this bad. They're really bad this year. It's just not a good year for them. Fact is, Duke's not good, and Miami's going to win this game by a lot. It's on the ACC Network, by the way. Miami's going to cover the 15-point spread.